First, let me say thank you to all of you for being here and participating in this wonderful event, not only to commemorate the anniversary of this great park, but to really highlight the importance of two wonderful people who, without their effort, we all wouldn't be commemorating the anniversary of the park. Bill and Hazel have contributed mightily to the park, the development of the park, to allowing so many people from all over Illinois and many from central Illinois to enjoy the great outdoors, to learn a lot about the great outdoors and the animals that are here and the lessons that are taught by the observance of their lives, I think is extraordinary. Without Bill and Hazel, we wouldn't have wildlife and we wouldn't have this wonderful opportunity. So I'm pleased to have played a small part in making wildlife the great natural resource that it is for our community. And a big, big thanks to the Rutherford family for continuing the legacy of Bill and Hazel. And thanks to all of you for what you're doing to help to continue that through your financial support.
You know, it's hard to believe that Wildlife Prairie Park is 30 years old. And I don't think that there are two people who have done more to preserve the natural beauty in and around Peoria than Bill and Hazel Rutherford. Their community fingerprints are on everything and will live forever as a testament to everything that they've touched in our community. From the Community Foundation to Holt Education Center to the airport, to the thousands and thousands of acres that they have been able to preserve for future generations. We owe a debt of gratitude and thanks to Bill and Hazel Rutherford. Congratulations on the 30 year anniversary.
I want to thank you for allowing me to be a part of this tribute that's being put together for two wonderful people, Bill and Hazel Rutherford. Bill and Hazel started out their partnership in 1937 when they got married. And I don't know of any other couple that ever worked together that long and stayed together that long. But they were beautiful. And the things they did in our community were just outstanding. And they'll be around for us to enjoy those things forever. I can talk for a long time about Bill Rutherford. But he was a guy that you knew where he stood, you knew what he was all about. So I just want to thank you folks again for allowing me. And I know that Bill and Hazel are looking down and I'm sure they're shaking their head, they saying, they shouldn't be doing this, they shouldn't be doing this. But it was a pleasure and I'm very proud to have known them.
And the luckiest thing in my life was when I spotted this beautiful girl walking home from high school, and she was my wife for 63 years. She was shy, but very talented. As a mother, it was her first job. She was very talented and a hard worker. She was always up before I was. Never once did I leave home, even during the war when I was flying these awful hours. Any hour of the day or night we flew, you know. And she would be up for me, make sure I had something to eat before I left, even at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Hazel and Bill were really, really, really nice people. And they put their hearts and souls in this place. Yeah, they really did. And I liked her, and she was always friendly. And some of the things that, you know, that when they first started, I think she worried about the expenses and things like that, but she was really a nice lady. I liked her. She was a lady too. And I miss Bill yet coming out to the orientations because he always came. Always was there, always had something. He was thinking about something to do, that was for sure. He was a visionary, wasn't he?
Both Bill and Hazel meant a great deal to the park. Mrs. Rutherford was considered the architect of the park because she spent a lot of time giving the ideas to Mr. Rutherford and drawing up drawings for him. And he always credited her with the design of all of the buildings and of the Eagle Statuary and some of the gardens and stuff. So she was here at the park quite frequently, just as he was, and almost always by his side. But it was very interesting on Monday mornings because she always came in and would do her morning walking. And you could see her walking around the park before she started volunteering at the gift shop. And she always volunteered every Monday morning in the country store and in the visitor center. So it was nice to see her presence. And the thing I remember most about the two of them, the memory that meant the most to me, was seeing them walking across the bricks hand in hand. I know that she meant the world to him and also to the park. She loved it just as much as he did.
The work that Bill Sr. did was creative and innovative and sometimes quirky and whimsical. But it is here now as an asset for the Peoria community. Most of the people that come to the Wildlife Prairie State Park tend to see the area around the central, sort of the central core of it, with the Merrill Woods and the animal trails and the enclosures. And that small area of the park that is the central part where the enclosures of the animals are easily visible is really a very small part of it. There's reclaimed strip mine grounds, there's overgrown strip mine grounds that the natural succession of plants has overtaken. There are lakes, natural lakes and artificial lakes, many of them accessible and available for fishing. A variety of lodging arrangements. The four cabooses that are modified for sleeping arrangements, some converted grain bins that have been refurbished on the inside so they're comfortably heated and air conditioned, but kind of whimsical sorts of things.
Well, the Wildlife Prairie Park's important for a number of reasons. One of them, of course, is just family-oriented recreation. This is a place that the entire family can come out together and experience the world of nature. The other very important thing is for people that live in an urban society today to stay connected with the world of nature. For our own benefit, not just to save wildlife, but we've got to learn how this earth works that we humans are part of. So I would say that there are very few institutions or activities that could be more important to the welfare of people than to have a place like this within their community.
My father had a little farm up in Bureau County, and the man who had farmed it for him for years had told us he had bought a piece of ground. He saved enough money to buy his own farm, so he'd be leaving next year. And so I was up in the neighborhood. I stopped by to see him, just to say hello, because we've been friends for about a time as a kid. And I found him. It was a beastly hot summer day, no air moving, sultry. It was a miserable day in July. And I drove up, and here he was hand digging a basement under the old farmhouse with a wheelbarrow and a shovel. And I said, "Alfred, what in the world are you doing? Didn't you tell us you're going to be moving next year?" He said, "Yes, I am, but I wanted to leave this better than I found it."